microphone. Well, thank you for having me.
You're welcome.
It's it was surprising to me, truly surprising, that I was asked to participate in the show at all. And I thought about it, and I thought about it. I'm not exactly sure I understand it right now why, except that.
Michael, we need to talk into the mic and be on the blue dot.
Be on
the
blue dot later. Okay, so. My work has evolved over many, many years. And I've gone through various stages. And I actually brought along a catalog from the Edison Place Gallery, which is a retrospective of my work. And you're welcome to take a look at it. It does go back into the 1970s. And that's when I really began to be interested in making art. Although I came from an art family, my mother was an artist, my sister was an artist, is an artist. And so it was hard for me at the beginning, actually. It was hard for me at the beginning to be able to focus the kind of time that I wanted to, because I had become a lawyer. And a lawyer is a law is a jealous mistress, and it's really tough to be a lawyer and do a good job if you really want to be painting and drawing and going to art school. And so I had to stop being a lawyer. Fortunately, in my life, I worked that out and was able to find another way to make a living, which allowed me to spend much more time with my art. So over the years, I've done a great deal of art in different ways and different stages. And what you see on the wall here, that yellow print is mine, the red print is mine, and back in the corner is black print. Now, these are screen prints, so they're a series. They are series. And and that is only one aspect of my interest. Actually, the real interest I had over these last 4 or 5 years, well, actually now it's been almost a year and a half, 2 years that I've gone on to something quite different than the way these look. I decided that I had to do for myself was to go through the process of working with every major color, black, white, red, yellow, blue, brown, gray, and it's in this book, catalog of examples of all of that. I did it first in paintings, oil paintings and acrylic paintings. I made a painting that was actually shown in that exhibition in Washington, which was 6 feet high, 8 feet wide, and it all started with a lot of color underneath, all kinds of color, red, blue, purple, everything. And then I would go about covering up much of it and leaving areas that I thought would allow the viewer to feel the power of what was underneath, but at the same time make it essentially monochromatic. And so I went through this process, and I made 30 to 40 paintings like this. I then started to make screen prints and then drawings as well. And they were all shown in that exhibition. Today, I should just tell you that I've moved on. I've stopped making anything that's monochromatic. It's all filled with color. And it is all out there. And yet it's woven. These are pretty big paintings. And they're woven with lines and marks and collage. That I should say one thing about all my work. What I want very much is to create something that has tremendous energy, has feelings that I have inside of myself, and then arrange in a way that makes it look like it all fits together. Every single part of it has to fit together so that the whole is just a perfect sense of managing space. So that's what I do, and thank you for listening.